आयो दे दे क्रेजी शी डोंट नो दुनिया। ओके व्यूअर्स, सो हाउ आर वी एक्सटेंडिंग बैकअप? So let's talk about the strategy once, and then we'll go into detail about the connections and all. So here is the strategy. So the thing is, Bluetooth music device already has a built-in battery to power it, but since the form factor is quite low, so the battery capacity is very low, enough only for 1 to 2 hours. Okay, so this is the main headache we have. So our main headache is the range is quite low, only 1 to 2 hours, and I will show you the form factor of the battery cell. So you can see this is the form factor of the cell. It's quite small. Next, also while charging it cannot be used. So this is the Bluetooth adapter which you are seeing. So while charging, this Bluetooth adapter cannot be used. Okay, so this is another concern for us. So what if we can replace the battery with a bigger one in terms of capacity? So as I showed you the battery, we call that cell. So that cell is inside this Bluetooth adapter. Okay, so that is quite small, but in order to extend its battery backup, we can put a bigger cell. But seeing the form factor of this device, we cannot put a bigger cell inside this. So that one possibility is gone. So what we can do is, we can make another casing, or we can make some jugaad, okay, and put a bigger cell and power this adapter from that particular cell. So that is what I have mentioned here. Yes, that can be done, but how would we fit the battery inside? So here we have to think outside the box, right? So every time you cannot think inside the box and come up with the ingenious solutions. So you have to think outside the box. So by thinking outside the box, what I have done is, so if you can't put the battery inside, okay, put it outside na. Car has a lot of space, find some space and put it there. So that's the plan. We are going to ditch the original battery. We are going to remove the original battery which was there and replace it with a bigger capacity battery. So let us see the connections now. So this arrow, red arrow shows that, shows here is the aux cable we put, okay. And here is the USB cable we can put and charge our phone. So now I will show you the connections. So this is the music player. This whole blue border shows the casing. Okay, so this is the casing inside which we have this lithium ion cell having 3.7 volt as nominal, 2200 mAh of capacity, and this is the cell name is 18650. Okay, we call this 18650, and inside this we have this battery charge controller which we call TP4056 lithium ion battery charge controller. So the good thing about this is, it will, in simple terms, this charge controller will protect this cell from overcharging and over discharging. Okay, let's go straight. And this is the Bluetooth adapter. So here are the connections. So the battery positive, so the battery positive is going into this B plus on TP4056. Okay, battery minus is going into this B minus on TP4056. Out minus and out plus, these two terminals give out the power from this cell, okay, until it discharges, like until it gets a discharge voltage. So we are going to connect out minus onto the Bluetooth adapters B minus, and out plus is going to be connected on B plus of the Bluetooth adapter. I will show you in detail by practically doing this in the video, okay, so don't worry. This is just a schematic, let's say, to give you a context on what we are actually going to do. And one more thing is, we can also charge this whole lithium ion battery using a mini USB adapter. So what we are going to do, we have a USB cable outlet on the music player. So we are going to connect that USB cable here and then connect using connect to this TP4056 using a mini USB adapter. So this way we can fully charge this also, and then we can get 10 hours of battery backup. Okay, so hope this works, and I am sharing this presentation in the description below. You can very well see this and comment. And talking about the calculations, that how it is increasing our range. So actually the range of the original battery was 220 mAh, okay, milliamp hours. So and the observed backup power was 1 hour, and we are putting a new battery, new cell, which has a capacity of 2200 mAh. okay, so this means that new backup time will be 2200 mAh divided by 220 mAh. okay, so when we'll calculate, we'll get 10 hours. So this means that now battery backup has increased by almost 9 hours. So that is what we wanted a Bluetooth adapter which was having a battery backup of 10 hours, 9 hours, okay, not 1 hour. And also in our case, what we have done is, by implementing this whole system, right, we can play music from this adapter, okay, from this adapter for unlimited time, because we have also provided charging facility here. So if you keep on charging this lithium ion cell from this Sony music player, then this is obvious that the battery charge is never going to die. This is the system, and now let's straight jump in onto the actual system which I have prepared. I'll show you how I solder the wires. I will show you the actual PCB, right? So without any delay, let's go. So this is the controller casing. So it's a 3D printed casing, okay, plastic casing, and inside this we have TP4056 battery, lithium ion battery charge controller, and this is lithium ion battery, that is 18650 cell. This is the Bluetooth adapter, aux cable. Here is the outlet which is going in into the music player. This is the USB cable, okay, this USB cable is connected here, and this USB cable is charging this lithium ion cell. Now just look at the circuit inside. So inside circuit which you are seeing right now is TP4056. So TP4056 is a battery charge controller. It charges the lithium ion cell up to a certain voltage, that is 4.2 volts, and then cuts off, and it protects the battery from over discharging also. You can see the wire coming out of this Bluetooth adapter. So there was no cable coming out initially. So what I have done is, I've opened the casing, which I'll show in just a minute. I've opened the casing, eliminated the original cell that was inside this. So inside this also, there was a lithium ion cell only, but of lesser capacity. So I just removed that and put two wires instead, where that battery was connecting on the positive and negative terminals. I soldered wires there, and these two wires I've connected onto this battery charge, lithium ion battery charge controller. So basically this Bluetooth device is being powered by this cell now. So yes, so here is the dismantled version of this Bluetooth adapter, and we have this plastic casing here, okay, we have this PCB right here, and the lithium ion cell which was already there inside this Bluetooth adapter. So you can see this the size of this particular cell, and this is the circuit which is inside this PCB. okay, so let us see this PCB a bit closer. So you can see the IC on this, and you can see this thing here, right here, this is the mic, okay, right here which you are seeing is the button which is used to power this on, and right here is the USB micro USB micro USB slot, this cell, and this is the aux adapter where we put the aux cable inside. See, B plus on the top, B minus on the bottom. So this is where this pouch cell was actually soldered. Now what I am going to do is going to solder two wires, okay, one on the B plus and one on the B minus. Let us now quickly solder going to B plus, right? So let's solder this. Just to confirm, we will check which is which wire. So I have a multimeter. So as you can see, we have it is showing -3.4. Like this white color wire is our negative and this blue is our positive. So we already heated. Let's take the flux. Just pulling this in order to check the strength. Okay, this is done. We have to check whether the power is coming or not. Okay, so we have this circuit here, we have this circuit here, we have the button here. Okay, let's press this. See, lights appeared once. Now let us check if it constantly remains lit. Okay, so we can see this is being powered on. So this means that we have successfully completed our connections. Now the two wires which I have soldered into this is coming directly out of this circuit. The two wires which is coming as out minus and out plus on the TP4056 PCB, so that is what I have connected onto the Bluetooth PCB. So one is the green, which is out minus, and one is the yellow on the extreme right side, which is the yellow color, and that is out plus. And these two wires are connected to this PCB, right? See, we got it.